slaves and the elderly as human shields. Take power into your own hands.
Ukraine is suffering its share of military casualties. Here, a convoy destroyed in an airstrike. This country is under attack on three fronts. The Russians aren't advancing as fast as many thought, but defenders remain outnumbered. In the central Ukrainian city of Dnipro, many have started to consider what until recently seemed unthinkable.
I don't want to lose my country. I love it so much, you can't even imagine that.
It is quite shocking for me, and right now I'm thinking about taking weapon to my hands, at least to defend my local districts.
Others aren't staying to see how it plays out. Hundreds queue for trains in the west of the country. Tens of thousands cross into Poland. And on Ukraine's southern border, into Romania too. Air raid sirens bring panic. Civilians now feel like targets in their own homes. Ukrainian forces are stalling the Russian advance. The fear must be that in an effort to break their resistance, President Putin may order a yet more brutal assault. Angus Crawford, BBC News.
Let's get the latest from on the ground in Ukraine, and our international correspondent Paula Garrett sent us this update.
Well, we're on the road to the capital.